The year is 1917 and the First World War is reaching its climax. Russia abdicates due to a revolution led by their communist leader, Vladimir Lenin. Greece enters the war with the Allied forces, and the USA declares war on Germany and its ally, Austria-Hungary, after Germany sinks the Lusitania, an American civilian ship. Amidst all the pandemonium, a fierce and almost endless battle rages on in Belgium. What is it called? The Battle of Messines.
Throughout 1916, the German forces claimed responsibility for attacks on passing merchant and troop transport ships in the North Sea and the English Channel. This was the cause of the Battle of Messines, as the British hoped to plan an attack that would clear the Germans from the Belgian coast, and in turn make the oceans safer for the movement of civilians, resources and soldiers.
But the British weren't the only ones responsible for the attack. Troops from Australia, New Zealand and even Canada participated in the attack against the German Empire. The Australians, who were part of the 3rd Division, along with the New Zealanders, fought from Saint-Yves to La Petite-du-Farm in the fearsome battle.
This brings us efficiently to the experiences of Australian troops in the Battle of Messines. Troops lived and fought from despicable trenches that were often bombed and infiltrated by the Central Powers. The trenches contained duck boards, sandbags and barbed wire. Due to typical European weather, the trenches were often wet and muddy, causing some soldiers to develop trench foot. Another threat faced by the Australian soldiers was the presence of diseases such as influenza, typhoid and cholera, which was caused due to contaminated water. For leisure, soldiers often enjoyed a cigar that was provided by the Australian War Effort. Soldiers occasionally received letters and goods from family and friends as well. Some Australian soldiers even trained local dogs to carry messages through the trenches.
While each and every soldier has a special war story to tell, one man stands out. His name was Ernest Pittard, and as he fought, a shell exploded right beside him. A shrapnel hurtled towards him, a coin in his chest pocket deflected it and saved his life. He wrote a 7-page letter to his brother Frank back in Australia, detailing his luck and role in the battle. Ernest Pittard was later involved in a gas attack, which he also survived. Later, his lucky coin was converted to a ring, which he wore to his deathbed.
Devastating one, killing thousands and injuring even more. Out of these were some of Australia's bravest heroes. The war had devastating consequences on Australians, killing 6,000 and injuring up to 10,000 more. The survivors also suffered as the war ended. Many of them experienced post-trauma disorder and other mental.
Furthermore, the Australian economy took a hit as a result of the Battle of Messines. The expenses included the purchase of weaponry and transportation. Also, the hit on the economy saw women doing the jobs of men. The Battle of Messines can also be considered as the major driving force behind emigration to Australia, as around the same time as the war, hundreds of Belgians fled to the Great Southland.
Assessment of usefulness / reliability. Image 1. Reliability. The source is fairly reliable as it is backed up by other sources. It comes from a credible author, Sir John Monash Centre, and has been produced during the war itself. Usefulness. The image is fairly useful as it enhances our understanding of the brutality of the battle and sheds light on major events / issues of the time period. Image 2. Reliability. Once again, the source is fairly reliable due to its credible author, Australian War Memorial. The date the image was produced, June 11, 1917, which makes it a primary source, and the multitude of sources that back it up. Usefulness. The image is very useful as it aids our understanding of the lethal living conditions faced by soldiers on both sides of the battlefield. Image 3. Reliability. This source is fairly reliable as well due to its origin, army.gov.au, which suggests that the image was taken on the actual battlefield and that it can be trusted to receive information from because it is. Image 4, reliability. The source is fairly reliable as it has a credible source, signed source images, a range of other sources to back it up, and is a primary source because it was taken directly after the Germans' defeat. Usefulness. This image is very useful as it helps us determine the impact of war on prisoners of war and makes out the victorious side in the Battle of Messines.